IVM. Hello and welcome to the Habit Coach Podcast, the bite-sized podcast filled with quick and easy, actionable habits. Remember, great habits create that awesome life. I am Ashton Doctor, your Habit Coach. And today's fun fact of the day has to do with the origin of the word focus. Did you know that the origin of the word focus comes from the Latin word focus? Ha! Now, you didn't see that coming, did you? Not every single fun fact of mine has to be a horrible word that I cannot pronounce or trip all over. But what I find interesting is what the word focus in Latin means. It means the fireplace or the hearth. It is the place where the fire is contained in a room. When scientists started playing around with lenses, they noticed how the lens would concentrate the light of the sun on one spot, making that spot so intense it could start a fire. Hence, the focus of that lens was the spot where the light's concentration was the most. And this is how we started using the word focus in our everyday life to mean concentration. I love this visualization of the origin of this word, the seat of the fire, the seat of intensity, yet contained in one spot. And for some reason, over the last 2 weeks, lots of listeners have been writing in telling me that they have not been able to focus. They're getting distracted easily. And what is the secret to focusing? Well, you know, I can't blame them. Being at home and working online primarily is a big drain on the system. It takes a lot to be able to focus during Zoom meetings, for example. Pets running around, children running around, family members asking you for things, non-working related things just lying around all over the place distracting you. Then, because we are now so dependent on our phones, we have to start the process of fighting the temptation to keep checking it. New Insta alerts, new messages. And then, if we don't improve our focus, our productivity starts going down. We do not really enjoy life. We feel tired all the time. And we live sub-optimal lives. You see, there are three important steps and habits to form in order to improve your focus. And this is so important that I'm going to share all three today with you instead of making a separate podcast for each of them and leaving you hanging or just teasing you with this podcast. The first habit is to declutter your environment. Do not have things that easily distract you lying around. Do not have toys or photographs or showpieces lying around. Clear up your area that you will be using for work. Move your phone away and keep it on a table behind you, or, you know, better still, in another room altogether. Think about it this way. Have you ever tried to see out of a pair of spectacles that were full of fingerprints? The lens cannot focus, and hence everything you see looks foggy and out of focus. If you wipe it with a cloth and clean it up, suddenly the focus improves. It is the same way with our environment. If we clean it up, suddenly, our focus improves. The second habit is that of planning your time and scheduling. Plan exactly how long you will be spending on a particular task. And this is because while focusing on one thing, you should not have to keep wondering what is coming next. Are you wasting time? Are you not doing enough? If you've decided to spend 30 minutes on a task beforehand, then you don't have to keep wondering if you're wasting time or not. Finally, you have to learn the habit of focusing on something. It is like a muscle that you have to train yourself to focus on one particular thing without being distracted. So this habit is something mothers hate. What I want you to do is take a pen and make a small mark on a wall in front of you, in front of the desk that you're going to be using or the place that you sit and work out of. It should be so small that you can barely see it, but make sure that you can see it. Obviously, please ask for permission before you do this. You don't want to fight starting at home. And if somebody says, no, do not do it, try and find a small spot on the wall that you can use and then use that for this exercise. What I now want you to do is sit and just look at that spot. Just keep focusing on that one spot. Do this till you get distracted. Then look away for a few seconds. And then start this whole focus process again. Look at that spot. Just keep focusing on it. Slowly you will start seeing that the world around you disappears. Your thoughts disappear. the world around you melts away and it's just you and that one spot. This is like focusing all our energy and our attention into one place. Now, what is interesting is that focus is just like a muscle. We have to train it. And this is the best way of training the ability to focus on something. Soon, you will notice that your mind begins to quieten down, that the focus on that spot begins to get deeper and stronger. And that's what we want. You are training your mind to be calm, composed, and focused. You know, I often get this as a compliment and a question. How are you always so calm and focused on these Instagram lives that you keep doing? People say that they enjoy seeing that calm. And the truth is that I'm completely focused in that moment with the viewers. There is no place else to be, so I'm with you. And as your habit coach, I want to see this calm in you too. It starts by concentrating your attention on just one spot. Just find that fireplace of attention. Then focus your energy on that spot. Soon the world around you will disappear and you lie focused and in the moment.
So start these habits and share with us your progress using the hashtag TheHabitCoach. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I am Ashdin Doc on Twitter and Instagram. You can find lots more information on my website, awesome180.com, or check out different content on my YouTube channel called AWESOME180. That's Awesome180.
I hope you enjoyed that show. I'd like to thank our sponsors this week, Paytm Money. So, a great week of shows behind us, and hope that you've been catching up on as much of it as you can. We had Abhishek Bachchan on Football Shootball. Yeah, let me say that again. Abhishek Bachchan was on Football Shootball. Did I mention Abhishek Bachchan was on Football Shootball? That was a fun episode. You should definitely check that out. Really, really deep conversation about cricket and things like that. We had Vikram Kochar on Cyrus Says, talking about Z platforms and stuff like what's going on over there. On the note, Maruk had spoken to Sanjay Jha, which was, again, a really, really interesting conversation. On Edges and Sledges, the guys are having an interesting conversation about, well, you know, what are favorite formats of cricket and things like that. So it's just really been a really, really awesome week on the network, and please do check things out. And with that, hope to see you next week.
Beta, did you know 79% of all scientists in NASA are Indian only?
देखो, इंडिया में टैक्स सिर्फ मिडिल क्लास भरती है. Everyone is just enjoying free, यार.
आजकल के youngsters are only interested in partying and enjoying. उनको देश की पड़ी ही नहीं है.
बेटा, तुम बस शादी कर लो. उसके बाद तो you can enjoy life like anything.
I will tell you what this country needs. This country needs 15 years of dictatorship. That is the only way to become a superpower. See the Chinese, how much they've progressed.
सुनो, तुमने ये WhatsApp forward देखा?
So what's common between all of these statements?
They're all absolutely rubbish.
Fake WhatsApp forwards that spread like wildfire.
And statements that defy any logic.
We are here to debunk them all.
We're your family WhatsApp group's worst nightmare. We're what happens when you read a book.
Basically, we're just a bunch of guys who want to cut through the bullshit of everyone saying this, how it won't be true.
So that the next time someone confidently squeezes out some WhatsApp or Twitter BS, you can look them dead in the eye and go, Uncle, please sit.
So join me, Joel.
And me, Tushar.
Every Mondays for a fresh new episode of Uncle, Please Sit.